Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we simplify expressions when we have both decimals and fractions in the same expression. And on this video, we do these three problems. All right, we're going to simplify this problem and write the answer in both decimal form and as a fraction or mixed number. There are several ways of doing this problem. I'm going to start off with just doing the order of operation by simplifying inside parentheses and just leaving it in terms of decimals for now. So I have 3/4 times. Now, if I add, remember if you add, you have to put your line up your decimal points. This is going to give you 8.4. So this is times 8. So what we have is 3/4 of 8.4. Now, if you want, you can cancel the 4 into the 8.4. That's like dividing 4 into 8.4. So for instance, if you look at it on the side and you divide, you're going to get 2.1. So that's one way we can go. Just going to divide the 4 into that and I get a 2.1. So now I just have 3 times 2.1. That's like 3 times 21, which is 63, and move the decimal in 1. So that's one way of writing it as a decimal. Now, once you have it in this decimal form, notice you could write that as a mixed number by writing 6 and 3/10. So that's one way of getting the answer. Right? How about if we do it this way? We have 3/4 times 2.1 plus 6.3. We're going to start out similarly, but I'm going to rewrite 3/4 as a decimal. So now to write 3/4 as a decimal, remember you divide 4 into 3.00, or maybe you have memorized that 3/4 is the same as 0.75, which it is. So you need to change 3/4 to a decimal by doing that division, and you get 0.75. Okay, that's 3/4 now. And then I'm going to add in the parentheses. So that is going to be 8.4. And then what you could do is this multiplication. You could do 75 times 84 and then move your decimal in 3 places. So that side work, or you can get out a calculator, you do 75 times 84, you're going to get 6,300, and then you move your decimal in 3 places, you're going to get 6.3. You're going to get the same answer. I personally think it's easier to cancel whenever I can, okay? But some people prefer to work with decimals and do multiplication and not deal with canceling. So that's two ways we've done it. People say, why don't you just show me one way? Well, because there isn't one way that's easiest for everybody. All right, so let's do it a little bit differently. All right, so we have 2.1 plus 6.3. Another way of doing this is simply writing everything in terms of fractions. So 2.1 could either be written as 21/10 or 2 1/10. It's up to you, right? You could write 21/10 or 2 1/10. I'm going to go ahead and just write 21/10. Okay. And 6.3 could be written as, what would that be? 63/10. All right. So this is a way of just putting everything in terms of fractions. So I would still need to add inside the parentheses. So that will give me 84/10. Now I want you to look up here at the top, the first way I did it. See this 8.4 in parentheses? That is the same thing as 84/10. But I just kind of went around the problem a little bit differently. And now I could cancel. 4 goes into 84. See, I'm not dealing with any decimals when I do it this way. So I have 63/10. So that's how to write it as a fraction first. And then 63/10 is a mixed number would be 6 and 3 tenths, correct? So there's the mixed number way of writing it. And then you can write that as a decimal. So as you can see, remember, by the way, this one you could just write as 6.3 as a decimal. So the fractional form for all of these was 6 and 3 tenths. That's if you wrote it as a mixed number. And the decimal form was 6.3. And I showed you three ways to do it, and there's probably a couple other ways that people might do the problem. For instance, instead of writing 21 tenths, they might write this as 2 and 1 tenths and 6 and 3 tenths, and might use the distributive property. Those of you who know the distributive property. So there's a lot of different ways to get the same answer. But you do have to use your order of operations. You have to simplify inside parentheses first. Generally, we'll be doing that. And then either writing everything in terms of fractions or in terms of decimals, or this first one, I had a little bit of mix of it, right? I did 4 into 8.4 and just wrote the 2.1. So I didn't change both to fractions or both to decimals to do the problem. So these can be tricky. Let's try another one. Here's the next problem. 5/8 times 1.2. This is a little bit easier because there's nothing to simplify inside parentheses first. So why don't you try this one on your own? And remember, there isn't just one way of doing it. But I want to have one answer written as a fraction and the other, and also it written as a decimal. Okay. So what can you do here? Well, if you want to write it as a decimal, what you can is first rewrite 5/8 as a decimal. So of course that would mean dividing 8 into 5.00 and doing that arithmetic. So that'll be, let's see, let's do it quickly, 2.625. So one way of doing this is writing 5/8 as 0.625. And then doing that multiplication, 0.625 times 1.2. And if you do this multiplication and put the decimal in the right place, etc., you will get 0.75. But you do have to do a three-digit number by a two-digit number. So that's one way of writing it as a decimal. And once you've written it as a decimal, it's easy to change it to a fraction. It'll just be 75 hundredths, and then divide top and bottom by 25 to get 3/4. So that's one way of doing it, where you're writing as a decimal first and then writing as a fraction. All right, let's try a different approach. We're still going to take 5/8 times 1.2. So what we could do is change this 1.2 to a fraction. Now, when you're multiplying fractions, it's usually best to go ahead and write them as improper fractions, right? So if you could write 1 and 2 tenths, but then you would have to write it as an improper fraction. So I'm going to go directly to writing it as an improper fraction. This is 12 tenths. I know that reduces. If you want, you could reduce that to 6/5, or you could do your canceling right now, which is what I'm going to do. So let's see. Is there something that goes into 8 and 12? Yes, 4 goes into both of those numbers. If you reduce by prime factoring, you're going to get the same answer as me. All right, what about 5 and 10? 5 goes into both of those numbers. So 1, and that's a 2. And so this way, I did it. I got my fraction answer first. And then I would rewrite 3/4 as a decimal. And if you hadn't memorized that, you could just go over to the side and start dividing. So you get 7. Bring down the 0. And that goes in evenly, right? Because 5 times 4 is 20. So that is also 0.75. So different ways to get the same answer. All right, here's our next one. We're going to simplify and write our answer in decimal form. Okay, so there's two ways of dealing with this multiplication of the 1/5 times 0.35. In order of operations, we do this multiplication first, right? So keep in mind we're trying to write our answer in decimal form. So since that's the case, I would not change this decimal to a fraction probably. So there's two ways of going about it. One way is to simply go ahead to divide because this is the same as 0.35 divided by 5. If you need to see that, you could write that as 5 into 0.35, and that's going to be 0.07. Most people could go ahead and just cancel and point 0.07. So then I get 6.9 minus 0.07. And then remember how we subtract? We have to line up the decimal points, put that extra zero here, and we get 6.83. Right, that's one way of doing it. Now, you could also change this 1/5 to a decimal and then multiply. So, what is 1/5 as a decimal? Well, you could do 5 into 1.0 if you don't know it, and you're going to get 0.2. Some people know that's the same thing as 2/10 and write 0.2. In any case, 1/5 is the same thing as 0.2 times 0.35 here. So you could change the fraction to a decimal and then do multiplication. 2 times 35 is 70, right? And then you move the decimal in three places, right? Because there's three digits after the decimal points, so that's 0.07. So you end up with the same thing. You don't need to really write the extra zero there at the end, right? So I still end up with 6.9 minus 0.07, just like I had right here. So I'll get the same answer when all is said and done. So these can be quite tricky, working with the decimals and fractions. And you could have a strategy saying, "Well, I'm just going to change everything always to fractions," or "I'm going to change everything to decimals," and that might work out for you. Sometimes it makes it harder to do one over the other, but sometimes you don't realize it till you've already done it the long way. So keep working at these. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.